Please stand up if you can.
なぜお前は悪を誇るのか。どうしよう、神の恵みはいつもあるのだ。また吹くことよ、晴れの下は雨。
By my word, take a step of faith. It's going to open the way to you, and you will be led by God's hand. The connection with the Jewish communities is the fulfillment of the prophecy, and it is the central call from God to the Tokyo Antioch Church. If you have a burden for the Israel Jewish mission, strengthen your prayer. Obey me, and I'm going to open the plan, and I'm going to fulfill my words. The Russian Jews, Jewish people, connection with the Jewish people, Russian Jewish people, will be opened, and it's going to be a door to open the door to the Jewish people. That there is a work that I'm going to lead you. You do not understand, but you are going to grow in the knowledge of. And you will be prayerful. Please sit down. We are going to have the Holy Communion. By the Holy Communion, we proclaim the death of Jesus. In this church, we recommend anyone who believes in Jesus Christ as his personal Savior and have been baptized to take part in this ceremony. And if you're watching the service on the internet and would like to join the service, please join the service. And if you're watching the service on the internet, please prepare the bread and wine by yourselves. I'm going to pray. Dear Heavenly Father, please bless this bread and wine, and please bless the bread and wine prepared by those who are watching on the internet. Please manifest the grace of your blood and your body through this ceremony. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Now let's have a time of prayer. If you have any sins in your heart, please confess them to the Lord. We pray in this prayer in Jesus' name. Jesus took bread and blessed and broke it and gave it to them and said, Take, eat, this is my body. Let us partake the body of Christ. And he said unto them, This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many. Let us partake the body, blood of Jesus.
Thank you.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the grace of the whole communion service. In the name of Jesus, we pray, Amen. Now we have our offering time. Pastor Miyashita, please pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for your fill of the we need. Now we give you the offering. Please sacrifice, please use to your work. And also, please blessing each one of us. In the name of Jesus, we pray, Amen.
Please open your Bible to Romans 8:28. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to His purpose. And another verse is 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Lord, please guide this time and lead this time and lead by your Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus we pray, Amen. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone who are watching on the internet, and good morning and hello. And we have a 1 minute short movie, so let's take a look. Please turn on the light. How many was able to discern the changes from the movie? Abraham's face was different. First picture of Abraham was very looked like Bin Laden. People of Israel is a special tribe, special people, because it was that country was built from the word of God. Abraham, according to the words of God, he went to the place where he doesn't know. And it was the beginning of the people of Israel. And God is moving the history with this people in the center. And there became a temple. And Jesus was sent to on the earth. And he was put on the cross, and he raised up on the third day, and Israel was dispersed all around the world. And in 1948, the country, the nation of Israel was rebuilt, reestablished. And after that comes the tribulation period, 7 years of tribulation, and Jesus Christ comes on the Mount Olive, and the Millennium Kingdom will be and the king of this Millennium Kingdom is Jesus himself. And Satan is put into hell, and the new heaven and new earth will come down from heaven, and Jerusalem, new Jerusalem, heavenly Jerusalem will come down from heaven to the place where present is Jerusalem is located. And this heavenly Jerusalem is a point for us, because it is called the this called the your hometown. Our hometown is heavenly Jerusalem, and it is called the reward for us, and we will live forever in Jerusalem, heavenly Jerusalem. So we have a citizenship of eternal kingdom, and that is the Jerusalem. A team will be sent to Israel from tomorrow, and we are going to Israel because it has a very important meaning. Beginning of the year is November for us, for our church. October is the end of the 1 year. And by the prophecy, God told us that told us to begin the year from Israel as Israelites, and go to all over the world. And that's what God told us. You may find it strange that we call ourselves Israel. And we Christians are a spiritual Israelite. People of Israel is blessed, but the people Christian people received blessings, and afterwards all of the Israel will be saved. The promised Israelites of promise are the true Israelites. And that is the correct understanding of the Israel. We have a citizenship of heavenly Jerusalem, and we belong to God. And from Israel we will be sent to all over the world. And we are sojourners. Sojourners, we are here by accident. And God has a plan and calling. God has a purpose for us to be here in Japan. And please pray for it. The team will be 64 members. But all of the members of our group, of our team, I mean of our church, will be there spiritually. And we are going to be given words from God to each one of us. Team will leave tomorrow, so please pray for it. And connection with the Russian people, Russian Jews, is being opened. If you, since you obeyed God, truthfully. God told us like that. So it means that the connection was opened. So it means that God admits that we truly obeyed God. The Israelites, the missionary work for the Israelites, Israeli people, is the main call for our church, and praise and worship. The work of the praise and worship is advancing. There's a milestone. Some people in some groups call us and ask for the work of the PA. There's a difference of the direction in the works of praise and worship. We are seeking the presence of God. The other groups, and other churches, and they are trying to they are strengthening in the direction of a technology. They are going in the direction of technology. So there's a difference, because we seek the presence of God rather than the technology. So the direction of presence of God, there's a great key, big key here. It will have something to do with salvation, healing, and the works, other works of God. And it directs, it has something to do with with the work of, works of the revival. And the many groups forget the lyrics of the song, but don't show that on your face. And so those people are very, the last pose doesn't, they don't. So technically, there's a need to grow, but the point is the presence of the Lord, presence of God. So this presence of God is going to heal the scars of the many people. And at the same time, praise and worship of Japanese people has a very much important. So when I became when I was a young Christian, there was almost no Japanese gospel songs. Only the exception is the song written by Joji Nagata. There was a little Japanese gospel songs, and we sang the American songs, Vineyard songs, and Church on the Way songs. And a foreign vessel comes to Japan, and they ask, what is the Japanese gospel song? And we answer, there's no Japanese gospel songs. We went to Mrs. Wombrandt, and she said, if you don't speak English, you have to speak through two interpreters, and the people of Romania wouldn't listen to such a sermon. And she said, then sing the Japanese gospel song, and they will respond. Who was in that team to the Romania? What kind are there any Japanese gospel song? And we sang a certain song, and she made a strange face. And we didn't know the reason, but we found out later that it was an American song. In the car, and when we were driving, I realized that it was the song made in the United States, and it was a translation, Japanese translation of that song. And that is the Japanese spiritual problem, that we don't have a wrong Japanese songs. And I think that we have now we have many Japanese gospel songs, Christian songs, and it means that we have advanced spiritually. Arechnikawa and the vision, and we spoke, had a meeting, and we talked. We are now in the middle of amateur and professional. We are going to into the professional area from now on. A very famous person is arranging our song. I think that God is reaching out many hands. And in the praise and worship, that work is now beginning to happen. For example, planned to go to a concert. It needs, we have to pay, buy a ticket. And we didn't know where to go. And a certain group, came to us, and they were interested in the orphanage, Cornerstone Orphanage, and they allowed us, our members of our church, to have a look at the concert. And God told us to study the concert. I've never heard such a story in the Christian churches. I've been in Christian churches in 40 years. But I've never heard such a story. And the concert will accommodate more than 10,000 people. And I see the God's hand there. If you are led by God, do not retreat. If there is no hand of God on it, don't do it. But if there is a hand of God, God's glory will be revealed. If there is no hand, there is no hand of God, we can't manage it. A memorial meeting of the Nishizaka will be held on February 7th. And on it's Tuesday, and a meeting will be held in the evening. And we will going to broadcast the meeting online. Healing has happened. When I went to Sendai, there is a lady who is about the same age as me, as I. And she was suffering from a disease, from the disease in the eyes and the ears, and it was not completely healed, but a healing happened. I'd like to thank God. And I was moved. Eyes and ears were healed a little bit. And that, I'm sorry, it was a man. And that man was very glad and rejoicing. And it influenced many people. If you receive blessings from God and blessings, wonderful works happened, even though wonderful works happened, you don't tell that to other people. And also in Atsugi Church, there was a there was a lady who broke three bones in the lower back, and she had a she had pain, and I prayed and it was healed. And what I thought, she was healed of the pain. Many people would be healed of the pain, but she danced and she was very, very glad and rejoiced. She's so happy. It's wonderful that she was healed, but she rejoiced to God. It influences other people around her. When she was glad in the, even in the elevator, and the non-Christians saw that saw her rejoicing, and they asked what happened. Healing happens, but that kind of rejoice, that kind of rejoicing, I've hardly seen such a person who showed such a great rejoice over the work of the healing. What happened to you? Your face is so grim. And I saw the miracle of God. Rejoicing in the Lord, it influences other people around you. So there's a work and the blessings of God there. Last week, who saw the special works of God? If you are not to raise your hand, if you didn't raise your hand, it's only that you haven't realized it, and you are forgetting it. And realize and rejoice in God and praise God. Today is the October 30th, and we are. And this is the end of our end of this year. And God showed at the beginning of this year, told us through the Word, Luke 3, verse 2 and 4. The Word of God. Luke 3:2-4. The word of God came unto John the son of Zechariah in the wilderness. Believing God is important, and what does it mean to believe God? Believe God, and it means believing the words of God. And words of God is the words of the Bible. We believe that the Bible is the infallible word of God. And also, God speaks to us through the Bible. And there's a need of discernment, but those are the words of God also.
でここで一章の9節、こう書いてありますね。もし私たちが自分の罪を言い表すなら、神は真実です。
First John. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive our sins, forgives us our sins, and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.So if we confess our sins, God will forgive us. If we don't feel that we are forgiven, even if we don't feel that we are forgiven, according to the promise of God, we are forgiven. Because Christ paid the penalty of our sins and He was put on the cross.And that is the foundation of our faith. And the receiving the words of God is the foundation of the faith. When the life of God begins, and it's very, very important to receive God's word.Because the works of God will begin. Reinhold Bonnke said, and at the beginning of his work, missionary work, very few people came to his meeting. But he had many promises from God.And we do have the promises of God. We do have many words from God. We haven't been fulfilled. But the works of God is now being happening.In your life, what does it need? What do you need in your life? The words of God. You need the words of God. And is your life optimistic or pessimistic?It depends on whether you have the words of God or not. And you stand on the words of God and you do your work. There are many, many words from God and the promise of a prayer. Seek and it will be given to you. Matthew chapter 7, verse 7. When I first became a young Christian, and people told me that prayers would be answered, and I tried, but I, my prayer was not answered, and I didn't see any people whose any prayers answered around me. So I thought prayers are not answered. If you are not good at praying, if you don't understand the prayer, if you don't understand the prayer, read the books on prayer. The book written by the people whose prayers are answered. And faith is information. Faith grows with the information. And God told me that I went to alone. I went to the team alone, and it was the team of one person. And God told me that you are, this kind of team will be the very will be the last in your life. And I went to Israel by myself, and I went to the there's a Long Beach Hotel, and next to it there is another hotel. And I want to come to Israel, but I wondered if I would be able to come again. And I went back to Japan, and I read the book by Pastor Masao Tanaka, and he said in his book that he prayed that he would be able to come to Israel for 10 times. And that rose, woke me up, woke my faith up in my heart. And I prayed that I prayed that I would be able to go to Israel more than 10 times, and then 20 times, and 30 times, and 40 times, and then finally 50 times. And somebody researched, made a research, and he found out that I went to Israel for 32 times. And I've been to Israel before that time, so it's about 34 times that I've been to Israel. And I prayed also that I would be able to go to the United States more than 100 times. And as of 103 times. And when I first went to Nagasaki, I prayed to God that I would be able to come back to Nagasaki more than 100 times. As I said in my sermon, last sermon, I was led to become an evangelist, and I thought about it. There were very smart people. People around me, て道を川 and Kenichi Arai, Kenichi Nakagawa, those very famous and smart people were around me. And pastoring is good, and sermon is good, and evangelism is good.And I didn't think that those kind of things is not the point. And I thought it was the finance. If you can do the finance very well, you can be successful. You can be successful as an evangelist. So the finance. And I was just reading the book by George Mueller. And Pastor Madoka. Pastor Madoka is going to write about George Mueller.
About
$37 billion yen moved through George Mueller. Prepare for the old age. If you are not prepared for we have a prayer. I think the prayer is the point. And hard time and hardship will come from now on. We can now rest. But it's because there's no persecution yet. There's going to be a hard There's a rumor. And the rumor said that when we prayed for the sick people, there's a foreign pastor in the TLCCC, he prayed for the sick and he charged 5,000 yen. And I wondered who is the foreign pastor in the TLCCC. Is there any pastor in TLCCC?There are some churches. Who charges some money? Charges some money for the healing prayer. When you go to Japan, Shinto shrine, they charge you 50,000 yen.And it's a misunderstanding. There's going to be an earthquake. Tokyo and Nagoya
性としては中心のところだけど、中心のところになかなか来ないんですよね。なかなか来ないっていうのは早く来いっていうんじゃないですよ。
And we don't have earthquakes, so they've been telling us that we're going to have earthquake, but we haven't yet. And it's taking a long time. And many people will be saved, and through you, you will be, and they will be. The number of people in the church becomes 100 times as many as now, the problem becomes 100 times as big as now. And the important thing is the prayer. If you don't pray, it's going to be a hard time. Many of you are devoted yourselves to God. The prayer will be answered more than we think. Prayer has a very important meaning. And the point is, George Mueller moved. George Mueller was given by God 37 billion yen. When I read his book, the faith in my heart grew. My concept of prayer changed. But my prayer life didn't change at the time. And my prayer life changed when I met the promise. It's a Psalm 34, verse 9 and 10. It's the word of the word of his life. And when I began to pray over that prayer, that word of God, my prayer began to see the answers. If you would like to be used by God, and you will be used by God, then have to make a sermon, deliver a sermon. And if you are going into the work of the Russian Jews, salvation of the Russian Jews, missionary work of the Russian Jews, you will have bear a cross. For example, I pray. When I pray alone, personally, I pray at least for 1 hour for the Thanksgiving. So I set my time. And I prayer of Thanksgiving is 20 minutes. And I go to other prayer. And these days my prayer life changed. When I prayed Thanksgiving, I have to pray for 20 minutes. And in my heart, there will be some idea that I have to pray for this, and pray for the healing of such a person. And the work of the Holy Spirit in prayer has been changed. If you make a plan, if you pray according to the prompting of the Holy Spirit, you can pray longer and you can pray better. What is needed is a prayer. And if God is with us, there is no fear. If God is with us, God is going to help us. For 7 weeks, I was chased by the typhoon. And I've been using the first class seat. And you guys do not you don't get surprised. But if I speak this out of the TLCC church, nobody would believe me because it's too good. And God is trying to show us how much prayer will be answered. And when I went to go on plane, God told me, you are not praying for the first class. Please strengthen your prayer. Prayer is a wonderful blessing. Please remember this. And also, this is the end of the year. God is telling us to thank God for everything.
So, 1 Thessalonians
chapter 5 is one point. I'm going to read again. Chapter 5, In everything give thanks. I'm sorry about certain thing. Through Malin Carruthers, God told us and taught us to give thanks. And many people listen to the teaching of the Thanksgiving, but they forget it soon. And teaching of Thanksgiving is a special teaching. It has to do with the past instead of the future. Promises concerning the future. So many promises are concerning the future. But this teaching of Thanksgiving is about the past. Teaching of God has one feature, characteristic. You haven't been on the first class. But if you pray, if you have, you prayed, and you haven't answered. You haven't, and you didn't get because you didn't pray, and I got it because I prayed. And those who pray for those who seek will receive. If you don't seek, you will not receive. So seek. It's important. It's necessary that we seek. Why do we have to give thanks for bad things and minus kind of thing, negative things? And somebody say, why didn't you send? Why only me have such a calamity? The Bible doesn't say. It's not the will of God to say that God, you are fool. We give thanks for the bad things because God is allowing that to happen. God didn't prevent it. And why is it that God prevented this thing, these bad things, but He didn't prevent this bad things? And through many experiences, God showed me how wonderful God is. And And through it, God's work will happen. If you go away from God's word, repent. And through the problems, God's work is going to be manifest abundantly. One thing I learned through Thanksgiving, But it's written in the Bible to give thanks, so I give thanks. It's a good standpoint. If you keep giving thanks, it's going to expand. It's like if you keep digging a hole, you find gems, you find gold, and you find ruby and diamond. While I was working together with Pastor Arai, and he praised me. He said, you have such a problem, and I was standing on the Thanksgiving position, so I didn't waver. But in my heart, there was a contradiction. There was a problem in my heart. There was a question in my heart. But I walked on the faith. If you keep praying and thanking God, I began to see God's wonderful care. And everyone, if you feel a contradiction, you continue and pray and give thanks and pray through it. Give thanks. But I still don't understand, so let me understand it, Lord. You are the one who gives us the very best thing. So I believe that you are going to give me the very best thing. I will be surprised to find your wonderfulness and your grace and your love. The first step of the Thanksgiving is thank you, Lord. I was caught in the overspeed. You are the person of love. So you are going to give me the very wonderful things through this experience. I praise you and I give you thanks. Not only giving thanks, but profess the wonderful things that God is going to give us. That is a kindergarten class of thanksgiving. Don't stop with that. You have the wonderful plan for this experience, and we are going to experience wonderful things, and I know it, and you are the one who gives us the very best thing for me. And praise God, and confess according to the words of God. Then, and you will have more spiritual power. And if you confess the confession, God is going to give us earlier, faster. Give us the answer faster. If you are giving thanks, but you have a question in your heart, do not look away from it. But pray it through. So express your faith, express your trust, and praise God for it. And you will realize. I was surprised. There is a gem in all that. And you're going to see the blessings and grace abundantly. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you and work in each one of us. Somebody, God has told somebody something, but God is leading you to pray more. Somebody's confession is very negative. Some can't stand up from some spiritual problems. And give thanks and praise God and confess. Somebody thought that this is the end. This is the end of it. Everything is going to repent. I'm going to pray for the sick. Let's have a time of repentance together, all together. Please pray for your own healing. Heavenly Father, thank you for being with us. Please heal our hearts, our mind, our mind and our body. Be healed in the name of Jesus. We proclaimed, we confessed the faith, health in the name of Jesus. Somebody's throat and nose has been healed. Somebody's lower back has been healed. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.